In the classroom, Talina brings this very unexpected air of sophistication and class with a whole lot of sass. There's no pretension in it though. She's very down to earth, but she speaks with a very clear, articulate voice, and everything that she says sounds very intelligent, even when she's cracking a joke. And she keeps us laughing all the time. We enjoy the conversations that we have, and it's always a good time because she's very intelligent, but she doesn't take herself too seriously.
I'm motivated to do well in school because my mom had to put her dreams to the side to raise me and my two sisters. And I feel like it's my top priority because she wasn't able to go to college to raise us. And I feel like I should live her dreams through myself and do even better. And I feel like I shouldn't take that for granted because most people aren't granted the opportunity. So I do that through getting good grades and making sure I can get scholarships and awards and stuff. So after high school, I plan on going to the Army as an information technology specialist and then going to Southeastern to become a computer engineer.
When it comes to Talina's future, I actually think she has it all wrong. I think that she's been given the gift of gab, and she also is good at listening to other people's problems and giving them advice. I see her doing something so much cooler than working with computers. I see her writing self-help books. I think that she could be the next Oprah Winfrey if she wanted to be. That person that people look up to as the image of what a strong, independent woman can be. I see that for her, and I see myself watching her at 3 o'clock on weekday afternoons in the future. I'll plan my life around it. One of the memories of Talina that I'll never forget is we had this great big project where we did the trial of Louis XVI during the French Revolution, complete with a guillotine and all types of things. All the kids had to play a role in the trial, and Talina, being the grand dame that she is, had to play the role of Marie Antoinette's maid, I believe it was. She was the classiest, well-dressed, best-dressed maid I've ever saw, with her hair did, and like it was almost like she strutted in with a fur coat, and I'm like, you're supposed to be the maid. And she was like, but I'm gonna be the best dressed maid that there ever was.
I chose Mr. Ward as my inspirational educator because whenever I walk into his classroom, he just has like this bubbly personality, and even on his bad days, he vents to us. Like, he tells us what's going on, he tells us his problems, and he lets you know that it's okay to not always be okay. And through his problems, I can learn from it. And I feel like I can go to him for advice on anything, and I won't be veered in the wrong direction.
I've been motivated to become an educator because all throughout my life, teachers have been very respected. I was very blessed throughout my childhood years to have a lot of teachers who taught my family, like my older siblings and cousins, and some who even taught my parents. And whenever we would see them, they were like celebrities. You know, they were household names because they touched everybody's lives so much. And I wanted to have that type of universal respect. And I wanted to have the work that went behind it, though. Like, I wanted to be able to spend so many years working with generations of kids and helping them see the way and showing them things about this world that they never knew about before, and also like bringing them to places. 2 summers ago, I went to Europe with students, and to be able to bring them to a place that I taught them about, things like that, making things that we teach real for them, has been the greatest experience for me.